Recording. All right. Well, I guess this is take two. 157 minutes left. We're plugged in.
I cannot begin to explain what just happened. So, this is round two. I already filmed this once. Well, I didn't actually film it. I sat through the whole thing. I smoked like 10 bowls. Answered a bunch of questions. The power plug down there, it wasn't plugged into the camera. The battery had run out. I had plugged it in because I knew the battery was going to run out. So I only captured like a small portion of the front end. So that is hilarious. So we're going to smoke some bowls and I'm going to answer a couple of questions because today is AMA Day.
I was always searching for the highest quality cannabis. Well, it turned out, if you want something done right, you're just going to have to do it yourself.
Need a bigger bowl.
I think we should start Obi-Wan. You know what? We'll start with the, I think it's the 32.
I do like the 32. It's a really citrusy pheno, super citrus, like the number 10. Like very orange. An orange, like the meaty part, not just rind. A little bit of rind on this one though. Yeah. A little acidic. I like it. Ooh. So, I'm gonna answer some questions. And hopefully everything works out this time when I get back behind the camera and double check to see if I've recorded it. And the first question I already know was, I'm just gonna read it. John Wan. I appreciate your work. How about some AMA and longer videos? Much thanks, dude. AMA, wish granted. Longer videos? Well, why can't I do longer videos?
Probably because you're a hippie and you have terrible time management skills. Here's an example. Today we found out that you don't know how a power cord works. It's 2015, for Christ's sake.
There you have it. I can't even keep my
your goddamn shit
together. Okay, enough self-loathing. Reality, longer videos, they take a long time to edit and they take a long time to render and upload and get everything together. So if I'm gonna do frequent uploads, we're just gonna have shorter videos. Plus, I have a lot going on. It's actually really tough for me to get to a lot of this now. So I've been kind of struggling with that. But I'm really trying to make an effort because I know you guys enjoy it. And I really do enjoy doing the videos. It's really become kind of like a fun passion of mine, so I don't know. We'll just keep tromping through it together, and I'm going to try my best to still get the science episodes and things like that, but, you know, at the same time, I just want to play with the cameras and play with my techniques and, you know, have a good time, and we'll just see where we end up. We'll just leave it at that. Longer videos, though, would... That'd be like a once-a-week thing. I could do a long 30-minute video once a week and compile everything together. But I really like the idea of, like, you know, tromping around a little bit more frequently if possible. So that's my goal at the moment. See, grow ma five? Oh, mouse, like, you know, oh, I got it. Grow mouse. Loving it, man. I learn at least one new tip or trick every time I watch one of your vids. Everyone seems to scream glass only for curing jars, but I use these wide mouth acrylic jars just like you. They are so much easier and faster to access and remove buds from. Doesn't seem to be affecting your product in a negative way, right? That's always going to be up to a matter of debate. Acrylic, glass, you know, kind of an anecdotal thing for people. I don't know if people say that they can tell the difference. We've definitely tried, but, you know, whether it's just random lab results from, you know, testing or something, nothing weird or negative comes back. All the terpenes match if it's in the glass jar or if it's in this jar, you know, from the same batch of the same clone. there were no issues and differences. One of the main reasons I grabbed these one time, this was a few years back, actually, it's like 10, almost 15, it's a long time ago now, it seems, I guess. It wasn't Baller Kern, it was another company, but I remember peaches, they were jarring them for jams and things like that. There was some issue with the seal. I'm not sure if it was silicone, I don't remember what it was. But there was a bit of a scare about that affecting the product. And so I kind of grabbed some of these ones to try them out. And they actually work really well for me, and I don't see a problem with them and the difference. And they're food safe and everything's great. So these are not a bad storage idea for cannabis. But to each his own. And if you feel better using glass, you know, totally makes sense. You know what? Let's smoke. This is the Ghost Grenade. Oh yeah. This one is just gassy. This has definitely a more OG quality to it. And it's got, I mean, some good nugs, you know? That's why we're calling it the Ghost Grenade. Like all the tops, you top it up. She's really, really held out. Even these kind of like side bottom tops are serious business. I am excited for that, this one. And I'm happy to release it. We will definitely release it out. I'm gonna try and get some cups ready for February. I will say that. I'm gonna make a goal for myself to try and do that. So I have a couple of cuts available. At least get it out there to a few people. And see what you guys think. Oh boy. I like that one a lot. Let's see. Yoda Grows. Why do you not have any circulation fans? I have circulation fans. They're on the ground pushing air up. We were running verticals down the middle. Also don't have them along the walls, like pushing really heavy on the plants. I don't like to hit the plants too hard with the fans. Kind of messes them up and the nugs and stuff a little bit. So I try not to put too much air on them. I like a nice flutter between all the leaves and, you know, no moisture buildup, of course. But other than that, you know, a light breeze. That's kind of how I like them. So it's working fine. It's also a really tight space in there. If we had a little bit more space in a larger area and had some wall space, you'd see some bigger fans kind of pushing around. Also, the air conditioner, I always run the fan in it that blows up through the ducting. So it constantly has air kind of moving around the top and pushing around. There are fans, actually. I guess that's the answer. Nick Arrington, how much does one plant tend to produce? I'm thinking about growing, not sure if I should start off with only a couple plants or a bunch depending on how much I get off a harvest. I don't think about the plant, rule of thumb there, one plant, you know, real big, produce the same as 16 plants that are smaller. You're gonna wanna go off, you know, your size, your space, how much wattage you wanna put in there. That's gonna be a better starting point. The Bud Guru, on the neem, have you ever tried azosol? When I get mites and thrips, this stuff works better than neem oil, powdered 6 times stronger than the oil and much cleaner. Actually, when they extract, like for Azomax and for Azosol, they are concentrating out, you know, some of the main ingredients. But the thing is that it is not the same as like a cold press neem seed tree seed extract oil. That is going to help boost the immunity of the plant itself. And then when the plant's immunity system is boosted, it can help make toxins to fight off bugs and predators that do eat it. So that is the idea there with a preventative spray. Neem itself in this application, it is going to help boost the immune system. I don't know. I hope that makes sense. So that is why we're using that. But if you have a serious, like identified a pest issue, I think that would be a great option. And that would be a next heavier level step. So, you know, start with neem and then move to that. Okay, one more bowl maybe. Let's see. Fernando Big Boy Gutierrez. Hey bud, are you gonna be there as a vendor or just attending? Want to get some gear as far as the Emerald Cup? We will be attending. Ninja and I will be there. Nerd and Shrimp will not. They have some family business to attend to. We did not get a booth. We got in a little bit late, and then we looked at our options and we decided that we would hold off for this year and take a look. Looks like they made a lot of changes, so we're just gonna come as attendees again. But it looks like it'll be a fun time, so I will film it and we'll be back again and we'll show how the event was. Oh, that just a note. I won't be back tomorrow because we'll be traveling, and then Monday, same thing. So we will return and kind of, you know, how Emerald Cup was on Tuesday. So for that one. But yeah, no booth. So no releases or anything like that. I know I've been promoting that, and we were kind of bummed about all that too, with all the factors. But in that case, there was another question about seed drop and whether we were going to be doing one or not, you know, come. And we don't want to do it directly like on the holiday like we did for Halloween. So we're going to do it on the release of the Star Wars day. So Lumberjack will be doing a release on that day. So you can keep an eye out. I will post a video up when everything is available. And that'll be your chance to kind of get in on those new releases. We have a Cookies Cross with the Jawa. We have the Jawa. There'll be the Obi-Wan and a couple other things too. So keep an eye out for that, and we'll make that announcement then. So that'll come in like a week. Got a lot going on, so I'm gonna wrap it up there. Just trying to get to little things every day. Oh, Obi. Obi. Thanks for joining me today. I will be back again soon. But until next time, I'm Vader. I'll see you later. Oh. What a train wreck. What a train wreck day. It's starting off great. Here we go. Here we go. Oh boy. Off to Emerald Cup. Off to Emerald Cup. Off to Emerald Cup.